When I first came to Sunset Media Wave, I wanted to release an album. It was called The Curtain Rises. John said it was ambitious. He said that there were a lot of artists before me that wanted to do the same exact thing in the past, but couldn't pull through. I thought I could have done it. I still think I could have done it. I thought if I had enough passion and spirit and, you know, energy to do it, I could do anything. So it wasn't like I thought it was easy or anything. I thought it was possible. I got to work right away, actually. And then quarantine hit, but I was able to borrow a MacBook and I created like 10 great beats. I even wrote lyrics to like 3 of them, and that would have been enough for an EP. I was set, really. All I had to do next was to record them. And that's what I couldn't do. I couldn't record myself. There was some sort of self-hatred I had where I couldn't take the sound of my voice in every single take, every single time. I would record something and then I would delete it right after listening to it. I put on filters, I put auto-tune on, but no matter what I did, I still didn't like how I sounded. I just wasn't satisfied with it. A week left, we had an assignment where we went around and talked about possible obstacles we were facing. And we got like post-it notes detailing feedback and tips on how to get over it. And that's when I realized I had red light fever. It's when you start getting super nervous when you see that red record button on, and it made sense. Every single time I had that mix in front of me, my voice started shaking and I got way too nervous to say words that were just written right in front of me. I had a week left. I still had time. All I had to do was to defeat this demon of mine. I didn't mean to rhyme that, but if I could get over this, you know, I would be able to at least finish the cycle and put something out, you know? Everyone else had their own thing. They had art, they had drawing, other artists, other musical artists, they had their own thing too. And maybe I still could have got a full paycheck if I put anything out, but I spent a lot of time pondering how to beat red light fever. Looking back, I should have been thinking about why I had red light fever. And in quarantine, the whole staying at home thing for days on end helped me realize why. It's because I didn't want to be clowned on for the things I made. From my friends, to people that don't even know me, to people that don't like me, so they're going to be like looking for things to clown on me for. I didn't want that. I was afraid of putting something I worked really hard on and still getting shit on by others for not matching their standard of these industry artists. And after realizing that, I just stopped caring. I came to the conclusion that I'm not going to put out, you know, something to please other people. I'm going to put out whatever I want. It's that simple. If I wanted to put out a 4-minute rant track over some guitar instrumentals I recorded when I don't even know how to play guitar, I'm going to do it, you know? I just wish I could have made this realization sooner, because at the end of that cycle, I failed all expectations and couldn't put out any songs.